Hi everyone, welcome back to this tutorial on how to customize the React circular gauge component. I will show you how to customize the axes, add multiple axes, customize labels and ranges, and add multiple ranges to the circular gauge. First, I will open an existing React application, where I already have a circular gauge. To learn how to get started with the React circular gauge component, refer to the video linked in the YouTube card above. I will run this application using the command npm start to show the initial demo. See, the circular gauge is rendered. Now, I will show you how to customize the axis. Here, the axis line is rendered based on the theme color. I want to display the axis line in blue and apply a background color to the gauge. To do that, I define the background property within the axis directive and set an appropriate color. To change the axis line color, I add the line style property and set the color property to blue. I also set the width of the axis line by setting the width property to 2 pixels. Looking here, the specified colors are set to the background and axis line. The default start value of a gauge is 0, and end value is 100. To set custom start and end values, I use the minimum and maximum properties. To demonstrate, I set the minimum property to 50 and the maximum to 250. See now, the start value is 50 and the end value is 250. Next, let me show you how to customize ticks. To customize major ticks, add the major ticks property and customize by setting the color property to blue. Width to 3 pixels and height to 10 pixels. To set intervals between major ticks, set the interval property to 10. Similarly, I customize minor ticks by adding the minor ticks property and setting the tick color to green, width to 2 pixels and height to 5 pixels. I also set the interval to 5. Now, the major and minor ticks are customized as specified. Usually, ticks appear close to the axis lines. If you want to leave a space between them, use the offset property. To demonstrate, I set the offset property to 5 in both major and minor ticks. See now, the space between the axis line and ticks is 5 pixels. By default, ticks are positioned inside the axis. Apart from this default position, they can also be positioned outside and across the axis. Let's see how to set the ticks outside. Set the position property to outside for major and minor ticks. Check now, ticks are displayed outside the axis. Next, let me demonstrate how to customize labels. Notice the labels are rendered in a straight manner. But now, I want to display the labels along the axis. So, I add the label style property and set the auto angle to true. Now, labels are rendered along the axis. Here, the labels are rendered according to the range and intervals specified. To display custom labels, for example, I want to add a degree Celsius symbol along with the label, I need to use the format property. Let me demonstrate by setting the format property with the appropriate value. Here, the value represents the data label. Look here, labels are displayed as formatted. Next, when this axis makes a complete circle, the first and last labels overlap. In such situations, I can hide the first or the last label and display it as a smart label. To demonstrate, I set the start angle to 0 and the end angle to 360 to make the axis a complete circle. Now, labels of 0 and 360 degrees overlap. So, I want to hide the label of 0 degrees. To do that, I set the hidden label property to first. You will see the first label hidden. The circular gauge renders in the clockwise direction by default. To render it anti-clockwise, I set the direction property to anti-clockwise. The labels are now rendered in the anti-clockwise direction. Next, you will see how to add multiple axes. I add one more axis directive tag and set the background, minimum, and maximum properties. Check now, multiple axes are rendered on the circular gauge. So far, I have shown you how to customize axes. Next, I will show you how to customize ranges. To demonstrate, let me first add a range by defining the ranges directive tag. I add a single range directive tag with the basic properties start and end values. To learn how to add ranges, refer to the Getting Started video attached in the description below. Look, the circular gauge has rendered with the defined range. Here, the range renders in equal width. To display it in different widths along the axis, use the Start Width and End Width properties. Let me demonstrate by setting the Start Width to 2 pixels and the End Width to 20 pixels. See now, the width of the range increases along the axis. This variation in width can be paired with a different range colors. To demonstrate, I change the range color to blue by setting the color property and the opacity to 10. Checking the gauge now, the color of the range has changed along with the axis. The default position for a range is inside the axis. Apart from this, there are outside, cross, and auto positions. Now, I will show you the cross position. To do that, set the position property to cross. Looking at the circular gauge now, the range is rendered across the axis. To customize the appearance of a range, use the rounded corner radius property. Before that, I will set the range position to default by removing the position property. To display the range with customization, set the rounded corner radius property to 5 pixels. Check here, the corners of the range are displayed with rounded edges. Finally, I am going to show how to create multiple ranges. To do that, I add two more ranges by adding two range directive tags. I have appropriately set the start, end, and radius values to all the tags. Then, I remove the start and end width properties from the first range and set the radius for that range. Take a look at the component now, it renders multiple ranges. In this video, I have shown you how to add multiple axes and ranges and customize axes, labels, and ranges of a circular gauge. If you would like to try out the example used in this video, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also shared a link where you can learn about obtaining a free license key to use our React Suite through our community license if you are eligible. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it helpful, please give it a like and subscribe to our channel.